Hello students, welcome to our YouTube channel Experience Tutor. Today we'll discuss class 12 physics chapter 2 electrostatic potential and capacitance part 11. And here is our welcome message. Before we begin, we request you to subscribe, like and share our channel. Please click on the subscribe button to support us. And also click on the bell icon to get automatic notification whenever a new video is uploaded. Let us begin the lesson. In today's topic, we'll study effects produced by putting charge on the conductor. Now, in the last class we have discussed, we considered the effect produced by metallic conductor is placed in an external electric field. Now, we note that the effect produced when a charge is placed on the metallic body in the absence of an external electric field. So, few important things to be noted here. So, we are pointing out one by one. First point, whether a metallic conductor is put in an external electric field or not and whether a charge is put on it, all such conditions all such but stable conditions the electric field everywhere. Everywhere. Inside the conductor is always zero. This is very important and a general fact. Second one, the charge placed on a conductor is always distributed only on the outer surface. Of the conductor. We can understand this by the fact that the electric field inside a conductor is zero. Consider a Gaussian surface every point on it is inside the surface. And not on the surface of the conductor. Hence, the electric field at every point on the surface on this surface is zero. Hence, according to the Gauss theorem, the charge enclosed by that surface is also zero. Point number three. In a stable condition, these charges are steady on the surface. That means the electric field is locally normal to the surface. Point number four. The electric field at any point on the charged conductor is E sigma epsilon naught unit vector n, where unit vector n is equal to unit vector coming out from the surface normally. Normally. So to prove this, we consider a Gaussian surface of a pillbox you can take as a cylinder. Of extremely small length, and extremely small cross section area, ds. A fraction of it is inside the surface. And the remaining part is outside the surface. Part is outside the surface. The total charge enclosed by this pillbox is Q is equal to sigma ds, where sigma is equal to surface density of charge on the conductor. At every point, on the surface of the conductor, E is perpendicular to the local surface element. Hence, it is parallel to the surface vector. E is parallel to ds. But inside the surface, E is equal to 0. Hence, the flux coming out from the cross section of the pill of pill box inside the surface is equal to 0. For its side, the area vector or surface vector is normal to E or perpendicular to E. Hence, the flux Hence the flux through it is zero. The flux coming out from the cross section from the cross section of pill box outside the surface is E dot ds is equal to E ds. Therefore, total flux is equal to E ds. According to Gauss theorem, EDS is equal to Q epsilon naught, which is equal to sigma DS upon epsilon naught. This is equation number one. Therefore, E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught. Why? Because you can cancel this one. So this is equation 2 in vector form. We can write E sigma epsilon naught unit vector n. If sigma is positive, E is in the direction of normal coming out from the surface. If sigma is negative, E is in the direction of normal entering into the surface. Now, fifth point. If some charge is placed inside a cavity, in the conductor, then the charges are so induced on the surface of the cavity and on outer surface of conductor. That the electric field inside the cavity is non-zero and the electric field outside the conductor due to that charge is also non-zero. And this is the end of today's topic. Please subscribe, like, and share our channel. Please click on the subscribe button to support us and also click on the bell icon to get automatic notification whenever a new video is uploaded. Thank you for supporting us and watching experiencetutor.com and Experience Tutor YouTube channel videos. Thank you very much.